Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and you know we've been doing this all day together. So today I want to talk about how you can become the overall highest in OAU post-utme exam, how you can actually top the list. And last year I talked about some things, and eventually our student became the overall highest and the second overall highest in the post-utme. But I would like you to take note, because the form will be out by August 14 and it will be ending by September 11. The reprinting for the exam will start by September 12 and will be ending by September 23. So the main exam is going to take place by September 25th and it will be ending by September 28th. Now, you all should be aware by now that OAU is going to combine two sets. The previous set, that was for the 2022, and your own set 2023. So there's every tendency that they are not going to, and from the calendar released, you must have seen that your resumption is likely to be October. So there's a short period to do many of these things, but that is left for OAU to determine. So now, what I want you to know is that OAU might not actually postpone this exam. And if the registration, the exam or anything, so which means that you have like 1 month to the exam. So how can you utilize this 1 month to do very, very well, to be the overall highest or be the best in the exam? Some of you have messaged me directly and been asking of materials here and there. I'm about to tell you right now in this episode. So the three or four things you need to do to become the overall highest within the short period is that, one, know your area of concentration. That's the first thing. Number two, get the necessary materials. So the necessary materials. Number three, form group discussion. Then number four, make sure you find a tutorial around you that can really help you, that know what way you set. That is that. Then number five, pray. That's the only thing. So you have to pray. So a whole lot of things used to happen during exam, you know, system, whatever. Then God has to be there for you every time, every moment of your life. So number five, you have to pray. So let's pick it up a notch from number one. So number one, knowing your area of concentration. There are some areas where you set questions. And if you're a secondary school student, you might not have even heard about these areas before. You know, when you see a question and you eventually know that, hey, what is all this? There are some areas where they ask you questions and you feel you wouldn't have seen before. I'm going to make another video for each subject to tell you the area of concentration, just like an updated video. I made one last year, you can check that out. But I'm going to make another one this week to upload for you to know the area of concentration. I promise you, if you can work on this area of concentration, I'm sure you're going to do well. So I'll do it for each subject, for you to watch through each subject, so that will take our time to quickly look at the short video. So that is the first thing. Then number two is that you get the necessary materials. Let me show you some materials I have here. Although within the short months, this material seems impossible. This is called one-time success. So we have one-time success. If you can finish these two, I know it looks like impossible for you, but that's why you need to do the third step I'm about to talk about. So if you can finish these two books, then you are probably going to do well. That is for physics alone. This is for the current affairs. I recommended this to my students last year, and they went through the book and they did very, very well. So there are many questions there that will test your brain, the aptitude and everything. So they are combined in this book too. Then we have this one-time success biology too. It contains a whole lot of things that way you used to ask. Then these are the chemistry. So we have the chemistry 01, chemistry 02. This is inorganic and organic. And this is physical chemistry. So if you can finish that, then there's this book, Excellence in Chemistry. You can see it even looks kind of voluminous, and it looks like, will I be able to finish it? So that's number two. If you can have these materials and you can have access to some pre-degree notes, then you should do well. Then don't forget your LAMLAT. So I know you should have been preparing all this, but so badly. It's not an easy task. It's not an easy job, but you can do it. That is the thing. So how can you do it? Number three. Number three is that find some colleagues that are intelligent, that are very brilliant. Be among these colleagues. One is that it is your own reading. Two, it makes you learn from everybody. Three, it makes you tap into their brains. So you will gather information from everybody, and gathering information from everybody enhance your own level of intelligence. Let me put it that way. Enhance your own level of brilliance, so you can face the exam and you are definitely going to do well if you are wise enough. Because when you have a short time, you don't start reading alone, you don't start opening books, you can't cover anything. So within the short time, even if you have not really been reading so hard before, though nobody wants to work with someone that have not been working before, definitely, but at least just give it all your best shot. That is what you can do right now. So work with someone, work with those students that are intelligent, star, especially the aptitude aspect. I want to believe, you know, that you are going to have three of your normal jam subjects. Like if you are taking government, CRS and literature, then the fourth one will be aptitude. So that attitude will contain current affairs, verbal reasoning, quantitative reasoning, English synonyms and antonyms, spellings and all. Then it can also contain mathematics. So don't say I did not write math during my own jam. So you have to prepare for the attitude. It's going to just be 10 questions and you don't know the area they will give you. The area might actually just be mathematics, might be current affairs, might be anything. So that's why you have to be... That attitude is very wide, is seriously very wide. So when you do group discussion with your friends, you will remember all these things. So it's important, group discussion. So number one, know the area of concentration. Number two, get the necessary materials around you. Number three, have group discussion. Then number four, probably you have a tutorial around that they know a lot about OAU, they are very sound. I would recommend if you can come around, sincerely. Because we do this every year. We're having a marathon class, which the marathon class is starting by August 20th. And we're going to have 2 weeks of lectures, 2 weeks of summary of touching those areas of concentration. Then last year, most of the questions we were able to get last year that OAU asked, within 1 week, we'll solve all those questions together. We'll practice everything together. You familiarize yourself with the contents of those questions. Then the 1 week left, we are going to have 200 questions per subject. Then after the 1 week, so that's 4 weeks, so that's 1 month, August 20th to September 20th. Every day of the 200 questions, we'll be doing the solutions and before you go for your exam. The one thing is that we're still going to reward you when you come out to be the highest. You can check our last year student, we actually rewarded them for their hard work. So come around if you have the opportunity to come around, come. But if you don't, look for somewhere around you where they can enhance your ability, they can help you to do very, very well. So that is number four. Then number five, don't forget to pray. Sincerely, there's nothing. Even we that we teach, we pray a whole lot of times that God should speak through us. And whatever you have read, God will bring to your remembrance. That is the thing. So keep praying about your life. Keep praying about the exam. Keep praying for the day of the exam. Keep praying that, and make sure you get a very good system if you are writing it at home. Don't get a system that when you load next question, it will take a longer time. In our place, we write the exam too. So we try to look for systems that are very good around, not desktop. We use system like Core i5, Core i7. It's a very good RAM that can carry out the work effectively. So let's make sure you get a very nice system, because sometimes the network used to log you out and you have to log in back. And the moment it logged you out and you couldn't log in back, your time would be running. So all those things, you have to avoid them. And you know, when you are facing a tough question that you probably don't know much about, the tension itself can say, hey God, how will I do this? And your system is now logging out, logging you in, logging out and all. So if you now have a very slow system, before you log in back, it can take a whole lot of time. So please be careful of that. So make all these things into practice. So if you want to be the highest, number one, know your area of concentration. Number two, get the necessary materials. Number three, work with friends that are intelligent. Number four, find a tutorial that knows much about OAU exams. Is that taken? So if you have any question, you are free to message me on WhatsApp. Maybe you want to know more about the exam will go. Maybe you even want to know more about our own marathon classes. You can check the flyer. If you want to know more about the marathon classes, you can also message me. There's hostel, there's accommodation for you when you come around. So we are going to do it together. morning, afternoon, evening, midnight. We're going to do it all together. So that is the thing. So we're not going to leave you. We're going to be reading, pushing you out, working extremely hard for you to achieve your dream. So if you have that mindset, please endeavor to join. Then how the exam will go, we'll provide you systems for you to write the exam so you won't have any issue at all. And God will see us through. So by tomorrow, in the next 2-3 days, I'm going to upload area of concentration for all those subjects. Please make sure you stay tuned so that you know where to read within the short period. Just read those parts that we mentioned sincerely. Just glance through them and you are definitely going to do well. So I'll be uploading the area of concentration for you for each subject. So please make sure you go through them. You know, I love you so much. And please, now you they help me before you go. Try and, you know, now click the subscribe button. Give me a thumbs up. Leave a comment. Try to say one or two things. Let me know what next you want me to talk about. Then I will let you know. So I'll see you.